Hello and welcome here at Convotherm, live from our show kitchen. My name is Connie and with me is Andy,
Hi, Connie. Our corporate chef
and the film crew. And today we are going to talk about our Convotherm Max Pro Bake and the different types of baking for bakery and our retail customers. Andy, can you please give us a brief overview of this session today?
Mm-hmm. So we will use the Convotherm Max Pro Bake actually today for two different applications. The first thing we want to start off is homemade baguettes. So everything made by ourselves, no convenience food. So we want to show the performance of the Convotherm Max Pro Bake for bakery who do traditional homemade baking. And the second application we want to do is using our automatic cooking, our Press&Go, when we talk about retail customer like coffee shops, supermarkets, where we want to do fully loads of Danish pastry or croissants. We will see.
Okay, and can you tell us a little bit more about the Convotherm Max Pro Bake?
All right, so yeah, actually it's available in two sizes, what we just see behind us, a 1010 unit and a 610 unit, since they are working in the EN tray or bakery size configuration. We have different loading quantity. Here we have a 5 trays capacity. In the 1010 unit, we have an 8 tray capacity.
And what about the configurations? Normally, we offer the Convotherm Max Pro as a boiler or spritzer version.
Correct, electric, gas, and everything.
Everything.
So the bake version is available electric only and spritzer only. Reason for that is, why only spritzer? Is the way how we produce steam and the performance of the steam. So in a spritzer unit, the steam quality is more wet, and this actually helps us, especially when we talk about homemade bakery items, for the extra boost so that we get a better volume, better shininess at the end.
And what about the controller? So we offer also easy touch and easy dial. What about the bake version?
We actually, in the bake version, only offer easy touch version. Out of the reason that there are certain features what is only available in the touch version, plus when we talk about press and go or manually cooking for baguettes, homemade, and press and go for retail, it's also easier for the operation standpoint.
And what about the other features when it comes to baking?
Definitely our legendary BakePro, what we all know from the normal general market version, is also, of course, in the bake version included. Then we have add additional steam. Like I mentioned, it's important on the beginning to give an extra boost on steam for a better volume of the dough. And especially for the retail version, it's really cool. We have add additional time. So when we have a fully load and we have the decision, I need it a bit more brown today, then I can add manually time without opening the door, without losing temperature or steam. So that's quite nice.
Perfect. So Andy, what do we start with?
Let's start with actually preparing our dough, what we need for our baguettes. We now have to do normally a dough what you should do a day ahead. It's kind of, it's better for the taste, fermentation. So we have just plain flour. So it's from the grain, it's the 550 flour. So it has more flexibility for the dough. So just the 550 flour. We have water. I need a little bit of yeast, not many. So just actually 2 grams is good enough. So we mix this nicely. Just add this to the flour. Whisk it. And like I said, so this is something normally you do one day ahead. So this dough, this yeast and everything can now ferment nicely. And when it's done, it's actually looking like this. So we see now this I made yesterday. It got all the bubbles in there. You have a really strong smell. Mm-hmm. Tastes good. And this brings us a kind of more intense taste into the baguette, so it tastes more authentic, more rustical.
Mm-hmm. And I can see here some more ingredients. And can you please tell us what they are for?
Basically, it's more or less the same like we just did. Now we have salt as an extra add-on. So this is just the fermentation, the flavor what we just did. So this one now, we have to get, or we have to make now the proper dough. So for this, we add this to the mixing bowl. Perfect. And now we just have to do exactly the same like before. We have the yeast now much, much more. Now we are actually doing the proper dough. We whisk this as well. So here you don't need to use warm water. You can also use just normal water temperature. You can either use now a kitchen machine or you can do it by hands. Obviously by hands it's good exercise. Here we are using now our machine. Important is now really to actually mix it for 10 minutes so that we just get a nice structure in the dough, flexibility. So this now, Connie, we have to leave it for 10 minutes and then we will see the result.
Perfect.
All right, Connie, so the dough is mixed well. So now we have to fold the dough a few times. So you will see the dough looks extremely soft and it's hard to imagine actually that this is foldable to do baguettes out of it. So we just need quite an amount of flour, and also this will be the bowl later what I'm using to proof the dough. So there we are. Connie, I'm sorry. Good. Now, Connie, look, really, really liquid, and actually you can see this, or not liquid is the wrong word, but extremely soft. So it's not like you would normally, when you're doing a sourdough bread, the dough is more thick. Yeah? So it's not so, I don't want to say it's running away, but it's really, really soft. So now it's really important to work with enough flour. And here as well, tip, 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 tip. And now it's fold number one, fold number two, flour in between. Number one, number two, number three. And you see now the shape, the consistency, the structure of the dough is getting different. And it's getting more and more the dough structure what we are actually looking for to make later on baguettes out of it.
And how often do you fold the dough?
Actually, just until I like the texture. Yeah? So if it's too soft later, it's hard to get the shape of a baguette out of it. One, two, three, and four. And Connie, that's it actually. So, and now we take the dough in the bowl, and now I let it rest, or actually I let it proof, just outside covered with a towel for 1 hour.
And why is proofing so important? And can we do proofing in our Convotherm maxx to bake as well?
Yeah, so the proofing in generally is really important to actually get volume into the dough, but also to make the dough flexible so that it's, how to say, the dough has to be relaxed. Yeah, and of course, if you have any type of dough, either you're doing puff pastry dough, bread doughs, you can also use the Convotherm MaxPro Bake for proving, especially in high quantity. The beauty here is that those units are absolutely accurate, plus minus 1 degrees. And if you go into steam, you have a warm, humid environment, so perfect for proving.
Perfect. Okay, so let's wait.
1 hour. All right, Connie, 1 hour later, let's have a look to our dough.
Wow, that's a big difference in terms of size.
Yeah, actually you can see that the yeast has done a great job. So it's like 3 times more. So good volume.
Perfect. So what's the next step?
Now actually we have to get it in shape of a baguette. So for this we need again our working table covered with good amount of flour. and also our baking tray. We will use later on. Now we take our proven dough. So from the texture, you already can see the difference from the beginning. It's now much, much more touchable, I would say. So we just fold it again like this. Now we have to portion us three sizes for three baguettes. Is this accurate, Connie? Not really, huh?
More or less, that's what I wanted to say.
So, portion number one. Portion number two. Flour again. Okay. So now it's important, actually, you are taking one edge to the other edge, you're pressing in and push the dough back like this.
Mm-hmm.
And you're making kind of pressure on the dough. So, again. And now we have this fold here. So this is on the bottom side.
Okay.
Super easy, actually. Now, actually, we can handle the dough. Before, it was so soft. Now we just transfer it through our baking tray.
Yeah. So now it gets the shape.
Correct.
Of a baguette.
It will get there. Same again.
Mm-hmm.
Pressing, and at the same time, just move it in your direction, and then you fold it up there. The folding is on the bottom side, and you can roll it.
Stretch it.
Yeah.
Perfect. It looks so easy.
It is. If you've done this a few times, and of course there are much, much more people than me, they can do it perhaps even better. And faster, especially faster.
You know, for me it looks perfect, so.
So, same again.
Okay.
This will be a nice baguette later on. And we want to have it a bit more in a rustic style, so that's why we also add some flour on top of those baguettes. And now, Connie,
yeah?
We have to let it rest another half an hour, roughly.
Half an hour, another resting phase. So why do we have now a second resting phase? Can you please explain
what
that?
What I just did to the dough, so from the bowl, the dough was relaxed. Now I rolled it, I folded, I transferred it to the baking tray. It's pure stress. So now, before we actually bake the bread, we have to let it rest so that we get a nicer shape later on.
Okay.
Another 30 minutes.
Thank you.
Okay, Connie, so 30 minutes are over. So let's have a look to our baguettes. Wow, double the size again. So before we actually start baking them, we should set up the profile, what we want to use in manually mode in our Convotherm Max Pro. And we will start now, or we show you now actually how easy it is to work in manually mode. So we start with combi steam, and for the first stage we need a really high temperature to actually push the heat inside to get the volume. And we're doing this in combi steam, so the steam also helps us for the volume. Time, now only eight minutes. That's enough, and fan speed full. The second stage we are doing now in dry air. So the first stage with steam for the volume, and the second stage is in convection air, 160 degrees for 10 minutes. Again, full fan, but now with crisp and tasty, also level 5. And we press start, and the Convotherm Max Pro goes into preheating.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. And while we've been through that, you know, can you tell us a little bit more about our natural smart climate and our Convotherm Max Pro unit,
yeah,
and the crisp and tasty you just used?
Actually, even in manually mode, we make the life much, much easier. So the normal way, either if it's baguette or sourdough bread, is you put them in a hot cavity. Then you spray water manually here in our natural smart climber together with combi steam. The Convotherm maxx Bake is doing this automatically for us. And then with a normal baking oven, after a while you have to remember, oh, I have to open the flap to release the steam. What helps you at the beginning to build up the crust and crispiness. Here, our crisp and tasty, again, it's doing it automatically by releasing all the steam moisture in seconds to create the browning and crispiness. So even in manually mode, all the features are there, and instead of going twice back to the equipment, like you see, one fingertip, preheating, in this time, I will cut the baguettes now, and the Convotherm maxx is getting preheated.
That's easy.
So, and now, actually, before we start baking, we have to make these typical cuts inside the baguette. So for that, I'm taking a bread knife. It's going much, much easier. And now we're just carefully, it's super, super soft, doing just the typical cuts, what we are used from baguette. Nice. And I think we add a little bit more flour on there. And you will see at the moment the unit is injecting steam, whoop, the volume gets this typical round shape.
Okay.
But we have to wait. The maxx will remind us when we are ready to go.
Okay. And I see that we are using here the original Convotherm accessory.
Yes.
And you can please tell us, why is this so important?
It is important for the baking result underneath. So on top, we have the perfect baking result through the air circulation. But the baking trays also, they transfer or actually absorb the heat from the cavity and transfer it underneath through the product. Is it a baguette, a croissant, it doesn't matter. And then we have a nice brown and crispy bottom as well.
Perfect.
Perfect. We just wait for the preheating and we are good to go.
Okay.
All right, Connie, the unit is ready to go. So let's take the baguette. Oh, thank you so much. And here now we don't have to press anything anymore. So our profile manually is set it. So we just close the door. And like I said, in total 18 minutes. First step, 235 in combi. Second stage, 160 with crisp and tasty to release the steam.
Perfect.
Perfect. Let's wait. All right, Connie, I think you can smell it already. Our baguettes actually are ready to take out. Ah, beautiful. Let's have a look. Ah, gorgeous. Nice, crispy. So now we have to transfer them on a cooling rack. Actually, they are really getting really, really big. You can see that. So the cooling rack is so that they are not getting too soft from the bottom, so that they stay crispy from all sides. Now I need to spray some water, and you can see.
And why do we have to spray water?
It's for two reasons. First reason is for the shininess, for the look, and also, believe it or not, with the water you have a better crust later on. So it's still, you saw I sprayed water and it's still crispy, and it just helps to build a nicer crust.
And how do we know it is well baked?
From the sound. So normally you lift up a bread either way, baguette or bread roll, and you knock on the bottom, and if it sounds too dense, then it's not well baked. But if it sounds like this, you just hear that it's nice, fluffy inside. And by the way, if we look underneath, it's also thanks to the right baking tray, a perfect baking result underneath, crispy and crunchy.
So can I taste it now?
No, it's still too hot. You should never cut or break hot bread.
And why?
The reason is that inside, of course, the fluffiness, everything is still hot. And if I would take a bread knife now, or I would break it apart, then the filling is just stick together, and then it looks doughy, and we lose the fluffiness. That's why you have to let it cool down on a cooling rack like this, and just be patient.
Okay.
You get your portion.
Understood.
All right, Connie, so now our baguettes are cooled down, so they are actually ready to be served. And I think you waited for that long time.
Yeah.
So still nice crispiness. And now let's have a look inside. Like I said, we want to have nice baguette. And I think fluffy, nice bubbles, so just perfect. And I mean, what is better to have a fresh baked baguette with a kind of antipasti or a kind of tapas, you know, some olives or like here, some nice fresh parma ham.
Look at
just for you.
Oh, thank you very much. Oh, and some cheese. Oh, you prepared so many things. Thank you.
Just for you. I mean.
And there's another one. So, JJ, do you want to try?
Sure.
That's...
He's also starving. All the time he's looking to us and he wants
enjoy.
This. Mm. And the beauty now is definitely, you know, it is so easy to make. It's fluffy. It is so enjoyable. And like I said, with this starter dough done a day before, it's not tasting boring. It has a nice rich flavor in there. Should I continue talking for you?
You just made me so happy. I was waiting for such a long time, but it is really worth it to wait. And this is premium quality, like from the bakers next door. And this, thanks to our Convotherm MaxPro bake. And doesn't matter if single or full load, thanks to our profiles from fresh to baked, it is so simple and we achieve best baking results. We have a great baking color and volume from all sides. However, not everybody has the chance to make fresh baguettes. And in this case, and very often, there are products on the market such as pre-proofed croissants. And it is not the trained chef or baker who is then using the Convotherm. And therefore, Convotherm MaxPro Bake supports with process safety and reliability, and also with automated baking programs. Andy,
yeah.
Can you please tell us why retail chains choose pre-proofed products?
Definitely the space what they have is the main thing. When you think back when we did our baguettes, we needed a kitchen machine, we had a lot of bowls, so we needed a lot of space for preparation actually. Here when we use this pre-proofed croissants frozen, the only thing what you actually need is a freezer, storage space, or a trolley to store the trays, and then you just go from the freezer directly here on the trays, and that's the only prep you have to do.
And how does the Convotherm MaxPro Bake provide best solution?
Here, especially for this type of product, we are using BakePro. Normally, if you take those products, you have to thaw them outside for a better baking result. Normally, roughly 30 minutes before you actually do the baking. So that means in total, you need roughly 1 hour for one batch of baking run. Here, with our BakePro feature, we do the thawing in maximum 3.5 minutes inside the cavity. That means I don't need to block this counter here for half an hour with the trays of croissants. Just from the freezer, on the trays, and immediately in the preheated Press&Go with BakePro.
Perfect. And why is the MaxPro Bake so easy to use?
Probably because we will use our automatic baking, our Press&Go. Here, it's just icon-driven, it's one fingertip, and it doesn't matter whoever is actually operating the equipment or wherever, the consistent product quality will always be the same.
And you, as you just said, Press&Go, can you please tell us a little bit more?
Mm-hmm. So Press&Go automatic cooking is more than just pressing pictures, obviously. Here the beauty is that we don't talk about time, temperature or cooking method like we did before with the baguette, where we said we need this time, we need this temperature, in the second stage we need this. Here, when we talk about non-bakers in the store or students, you know, part-time people who do this bake-off in coffee shops, here we want or we need to have either in the north, in the south, in the west, always the same product quality. And the beauty is everything you need to know is linked and stored in the profiles with Press&Go. So that's why I said you only need your finger, press the picture, and the unit will ask you how many trays and what's next. And I show you this now. We want to do croissants, and it's nice to see you have a name. You don't even have to speak, in this case, German, actually, to identify the product, what you're looking for. Now we see the tray view is popping up, and now the unit is asking me how many trays of croissants I actually want to do. So we have 6 trays on the counter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, Connie, if you would be so kind and open the door, we can directly start with the baking of our croissants. So here also, like we said, we are using the bakery size, so it's wider. So the total quantity of trays is 8 trays. And the beauty is we have a wider gap, so I can even go with bigger products so that the product can rise nicely in size. And remember, not thawed at all. So they are deep frozen. So we do with Press&Go the thawing now inside the cavity. Thank you very much, Connie. And there we are.
Perfect. So now we're using automated baking. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And we saw the tray view. Yeah. And remember when you cook manually or bake manually, mm-hmm. we use the tray timer.
Yeah.
So can you tell us, please, the big difference between tray timer and tray view?
Yeah. So the tray timer we mostly use in manually mode in a la carte cooking situations. So the key difference is that in tray timer, we are adding manually different times to the tray position or to the products. Versus in tray view, what we see here, we actually add a whole profile, multi-stage profile, all the knowledge, all the different steps are actually on each shelf selectable with the tray view. And the beauty here is as well, I'm able to do mix loading. The unit will offer me and show me, hey, if you want to do perhaps a cinnamon roll to your croissants, this is possible. Plus, with tray view, what we see here, there's also compensation behind it. That means as more products I load inside, as longer will be the timing. So the unit is adjusting to every situation, even when there's an interruption of the door opening. So long story short, with Press and Go, absolutely consistent baking quality wherever is operating it.
And Convotherm MaxPro Bake helps saving energy thanks to the triple glass door. And we have a perfectly illuminated cooking chamber due to our LED lighting.
Yeah, I mean, I really love it. I can clearly see from top, center, bottom, even to the rear end, what's going on each individual tray. So makes my life easier. Yeah, Connie, so now it takes 19 minutes from now on until we get a signal that our fresh baked, unthawed croissants are ready.
I'm looking forward to it.
Perfect. All right, Connie, I think you can hear it already and you can see it on our display that our croissants are ready. So let's take them out and have a look how they will look like.
Oh, the smell.
Tray number 1, beautiful. Tray number 2. And number 3. Oh, I can already tell you, Connie, that they are absolutely perfectly even. Nice. Every single croissant on each tray looks the same. Perfect. And our last tray, there we are. So isn't that beautiful, Connie? I mean, we have now here 60 croissants in just 21 minutes in this case. Every single croissant looked the same, and we didn't talk about time, temperature, and cooking method, thanks to our Press and Go automatic cooking.
Yeah. And you know, I'm just still astonished. It looks perfectly and it smells great. And what makes a good croissant? Andy.
The volume, obviously. Mm-hmm. The shininess. So when you see a croissant, when it's not shiny, then you can see it from a bakery perspective, there was not enough steam in the cavity. So natural smart climate, BakePro, everything provides the guarantee of success. So beside the volume, of course, also the crust, how stable is the croissants, and with the right trays, of course, the baking result underneath. So And finally, now I cannot cut it, but inside you can see, feel this already, that it's inside perfectly baked.
So, thanks to our Convotherm production management and its Press&Go, that's what we've seen today, the quality management with the BakePro function and the climate management with the airflow management, we save time and guarantee consistently best baking results. And for more information around the Convotherm Max Pro Bake and the complete Convotherm Max Pro family, please visit our website under www.convotherm.com. And now I want to thank you, Andy.
Thank you. And thanks for joining us actually today.
Yes, and we want to say goodbye right now and have a good time.
Bye.
See ya.